You have a dog? A little chow or something?
No, Helen.
Is that a raincoat?
Yes, it is. In 87, Huey released this. Four, their most accomplished album. I think their undisputed masterpiece is Hip to Be Square. A song so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics. But they should, because it's not just about the pleasures of conformity and the importance of trends. It's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul!
Communion After Dark.
Incinerate. 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 Incinerate.
Incinerate.
Yeah. everyone, and welcome to another edition of Communion After Dark. I'm DJ Tom, and we have a very special guest with us in the studio of Dark Dreams this week, Mr. Daniel Graves of Aesthetic Perfection.
Hello, hello.
Yeah.
In the internet studio. Thank you guys for having me.
So thank you for having us here again.
Yeah, that's right. That was like the third time he's been on the show. That's really awesome.
I think it's the third time, but every time it's a little different. Our technology is a little different each time.
Just gets better.
This is the first time we're seeing him on camera.
True. Yes. Very true.
All right. You just heard, I decided to play an older track, but this was Aesthetic Perfection and their song called I Belong You to You from their first release, Close to Human, on Bracktune Records. All right, and then prior to that, in my set, we heard a band called Das Werk, which I found out was a side project of Synthron, and the song was called, let's see, Schwarz's Horn, the SITD remix from their new album. Let's see if that's a silent A or Eshma.
Eshma? I'd say
on
it's
on Scanner Records.
Daniel might have more info on that.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I mean, Das Werk and Schwarz ist Horn, but I don't think Eschma is a German word. And if it is, okay. I apologize for saying it wrong.
Well, prior to that, we heard New Street Cleaner with a song called Berserker Class Behemoth Warmack. And that's from their latest, like, I could put Fuck Berserker in front of that. And that's from their new Edge album. Let's see, I forgot. That's on Vigilante Noir.
Yeah, I think that's all music for their Street Cleaner video game that you can get on Steam. So it's all cyberpunk, whatever, video game music. Before that, Gold played Hatari, which we love, Weirdos from Iceland, with the song Spillin' Gardens, the ESA remix on the Neslutrans remixed release on Spicamila.
All right.
Great track.
Good job. The third song in Gold set was by Funker Vogt, whatever. I apologize. Again, I can never say that properly. And the name of the song was Supernova. That is off their brand new EP, which is a bunch of, well, basically it's a formula. It's a formula for Element 115, which is the name of their album. So yeah. Lance explained the whole molecular breakdown of this formula, but I think I saw that on like a message or something, but I don't have any clue what the molecular breakdown is of that. So
Megan said we should call it the 8675309 album EP.
Oh my gosh. So we messaged Lance. I messaged Lance and I was like, you're a scientist. What does this EP name mean? And he said, that is the electron shell configuration of element 115. So they're staying in theme. And, you know, this long, unpronounceable formula EP name.
Good job. Yeah.
They did their research.
And Lance knows, of course.
Lance knows everything.
Our buddy at FSU.
Mm-hmm. One of the CAD scientists.
Yep. And that's on Repo Records. It's a brand new EP they just released on their label, Repo Records. So check that out. It's I'm sure some really good stuff on there. Go ahead, Gold.
And then prior to that, we heard brand new Leather Strip with a song called Silent Sin from his latest release, Back to Industry, out on his label. And I started
it was
off.
Label.
We could put Label. Label.
Patty Label.
Yeah, that's right. And then I started off with, let's see, Wei Jan, with a song called Incinerate. And that's the Asylum remix from the Incinerate EP out on Remission Entertainment.
Good job. All right. So we're going to do a shot of the week to honor our special guest, Daniel. Yep. We're very excited to have him on here. Very excited.
Let's see. If we can get the show to get 500 likes like he did, he has to give away something.
What?
Oh. Yeah.
No more of that. That was a big mistake. I don't know what I was thinking there.
You just weren't. That's all.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers, everyone.
Now drink your drink.
Yeah.
I think I just can't handle liquor.
Daniel, what was your shot?
So, I've recently gotten into rum and don't really know why. It just sort of happened this way. And I was at the store last weekend and there's a Austrian rum. You know, rum usually comes from the Caribbean. Yeah.
Right.
And this is just called organic premium rum from Fahrthofer.
That's like a delicacy. Like,
yeah, but here's the thing. It's not good. it's like not good
at all. It's like normal rum.
Good Caribbean rum's good, but this, you know, it's not like Bacardi or anything like that, which is terrible. But this Fahrthofer is like, the packaging was so fancy though, and I was like, I want this.
Gotta try.
Like, yeah, organic, it looks awesome. Great. It's got the sugar cane on it. It's not good.
But all right, so we're gonna talk to Daniel some more. Of course, he's got a DJ set as well coming up, which will be soon. Yeah. We'll be talking to him about his music that he's putting out now and all his new projects that he has going on. Mouse is going to be next. And before we go to Mouse's set, real quick, some self-promotion. We want to thank everybody who's been subscribing to our YouTube channel. We hope that you've been enjoying the shows. And please continue subscribing if you have not. We are also on our new platform, Heart This. So if you like Mixcloud, you can go to Heart This. It's a little bit of a friendlier platform to listen to our show because you can actually rewind the show without having to stop, go back, and whatever. You know, Mixcloud's got some tendencies that do not allow those things to happen, obviously. So, all right. And thank you to everybody who's been tuning into our Twitch streams as well. Again, we're on Twitch every Friday with videos, and every Saturday, Mouse is usually DJing a set on Saturday evenings. And we are in the Eastern Standard Time Zone over here in Florida. So just in case, because I know not everybody's in the same time zone as us. But we hope to see you on Twitch. So we have 3 more days left on our raffle that we're going to be doing at the end of the month. So if you want to donate to our show and continue to help us out, you know, as we appreciate everybody who's been doing it this month, we will be doing the raffle at the end of the month, picking winners. We currently have the 2 matte black vinyls that we'll be giving away. I believe I said 3 before, but it's going to be 2, and which it's more than generous of the band to give us those 2 vinyls. We have the shot glasses that we made for Community After Dark, which we won't be making many more of those. So jump on those. And we have the Community After Dark banner as well that we're going to be giving away. And maybe a few other items as well before the month is out. We'll let you know. Just check out our Facebook page and we'll have all the information up there. We'll probably put it up on Instagram as well. All right, Mouse is next.
This is Community After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Mouse.
Of course. torturing me.
Thank you.
get chased in my nightmares. Why would they leave me alone? It always comes from my subconscious. All result fears from their best. It drives me crazy, addicted to destruction. Why they keep saving the same rain? I fall in the heart into old fears, missing out the last duration days. I go through the days of my decisions and didn't bring our dreams to the burst. I fall in the heart into old dreams, don't let fear make them come true. I bless all the days of my freedom, I'm gonna decide to change everything. Continuous errors. Why are you still making them? Searching for the reasons. Real lose a victor. Only self-incrimination. Feel my fears and doubts. Eternal monologue. First to make a decision. End of the ruins of my best illusions. Taking the first hot step to. I fall in the heart into old fears, missing out the last glacial days. I go through the days of my decisions that didn't bring our dreams to the burst. I fall in the heart into old dreams, don't let fear make them come true. I bless all the days of my freedom, I've done a decision to change everything.
Psychic attacking from all sides. Then you sent a text.
right, welcome back. Communion After Dark. I'm Mouse, and that was my set. I tried to mix up a bunch of electro with post-punk. All right, last song I played was Corrine, from Philadelphia. And this is their new track, Sunshine, that just released last Friday. It's just a single that you can pick up on Bandcamp. Before that was In My Despair, a band out of Russia, with the song Indecision. And that's a very short EP called Indecision. There's about 5 tracks on there. Strongly recommend that. And then before that, I played last week's guest, Kill Shelter and Antipole, with the song Of Roses and Thorns from their new release, A Haunted Place. And that just released last Friday. It's available on Manic Depression Records, and you could pick it up also on Kill Shelter's Bandcamp, also Antipole's Bandcamp.
All right, prior to that, Mouse's 4th song in her set was Kanga with her brand new track, Touch. And that is on her album, You and I Will Never Die, which you can pick up on Artifact Records. It is available now for purchase. I think it was released just this past Friday.
Yep. Brand new.
I got my physical copy from Amazon.
Yeah, we've been playing the singles that she's been releasing, but now the album is finally out.
Nice.
Prior to that, we heard Brand New Mechanical Moth with a song called Undead on the Dance Floor. Male. Is there a female version too on there?
Okay, so the album is called Mirrors. It's 2 discs. It's basically the same album twice. So there's like 11 tracks twice. One is all the female versions and one is all the male versions.
And that's from their new Mirrors CD, as Mouse said.
That is on Scanner as well.
Scanner, yeah.
Before that was For All the Emptiness with the song Taking Back Control. This was the Frozen Plasma remix. It was a hard toss-up of whether to play the Assemblage 23 version or the Frozen Plasma version. But I like this one a little bit better. And that's on the Taking Back Control single. I think it's a single because it's just that track, several different remixes. And you can get that on Infected Recordings.
Yes. I'm glad you didn't play the Assemblage 23 one because that's the one I played last week.
What?
Nobody's paying attention to anything.
Or 2 weeks ago. All right, go.
Right over my set. Before that, I started out with Alpha Quadrant, friends of ours who we know. That was the song Subspace, the Stranger remix. And we did play the original version before, but I like this remix. It's a little bit punchier. That's on their Subspace single that you can get on Bandcamp. Yeah, Casey and Kayla.
All right. Okay, Kayla's in that. Good deal.
Kayla's in this.
All right. Nice. All right, so we have Mr. Graves' DJ set coming up next. But I think Mouse had some questions she wanted to ask him. So fire away, Mouse.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, so Daniel, we already know that this year you're doing this cool thing where you're putting out 1 song a month. That's the big news. We are 3 months in?
3 months, yeah.
And what you've put out so far is phenomenal. So I had to ask, how has this changed your music writing process?
That's a big,
probably a long story, but I mean, you know, anything you can share would be great.
Yeah, so let's see if I can give you the Cliff's Notes version of it. It's like when I was thinking about what I wanted to try to do this year, because, you know, after everything that went down during 2020, right, you know, the future of 2021 was just very, very unclear. And I had spent the majority of 2020 like not really doing that much. I mean, okay, yeah, I released a single and I did the cover version for Halloween, but I felt like I was writing a lot of music but not actually finishing much, and it was kind of like really getting me into a funk. And I was like, look, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to tour in 2021. I have no real idea what I have, you know, I have no control over anything. So my thought was like, okay, let me do something that I do have control over, right? Like, let me promise myself that I'm going to not only finish one song every single month, but actually release it. And it sounded like such a great idea before I, you know, headed down the path, before I started actually trying to do this, because it's so much more work than I had ever like actually anticipated. But I mean, you know, now we're like you said, we're 3 months in, and I've dropped three singles, and it's been a whirlwind. Like, really, like, you don't have time to kind of stop and appreciate the victories, but you also don't really have so much time to like mourn the failures or whatever, if there have been any, you know, that type of thing. It's like when you're a creator, you just spend a lot of time like overthinking everything, and I don't have the luxury of overthinking. It's just like create, and then like let history decide whether or not it sucks. So it's been a very very interesting process, but it's been really, really, I want to say, like, I don't, it's just like enlightening. And the fact that you can sort of just create in this sense of you're just in the moment, right? Which you so rarely are when you're trying to be creative. You're just always thinking about whether or not what you're doing is good or bad, or people are going to like it. You're just like, oh crap, I got to get this done. I can't worry about anything else.
Well, it's turned out amazing. I know you have people every month waiting, and they're like, give it to me. But yeah, what you've put out, those last three singles are just top-notch perfection. So whatever you're doing, it's working.
I'm so glad that people like it. And I think something that I didn't really consider when I started on this road was the fact that, like, not only does it give me something to do every month, you know, a way to keep myself busy, but it also gives like people something to look forward to every month. And, you know, when people are writing me saying like, oh my God, you know, I loved your last single, and I know that something new is coming out in like 2 weeks, it all, you know, I get so excited and I have something to look forward to. That's a great feeling. So it just, you know, it's like I said, it's a lot of work, it's a whirlwind, it's crazy, but it's just a really it's really nice to have this, I don't know, it's like this sort of relationship with the listeners that I didn't have before.
So when does the fourth single come out? Because I know it's getting close.
Yeah, so the way that it's all structured is that, like, I was going to have a new song every... The song would either drop the first or the second Friday of a new month. And so far, I think outside of SEX, everything has come out on the first Friday, because I was going to release SEX on the first Friday of January, but that was actually January 1st. So I was like, that's probably a bad idea to release a new song on New Year's Day. So I pushed back a week.
Yeah.
So I've got Dead Zone, which is the next single that is scheduled to come out on April 9th. And then Gravity, I think, is on May 12th. I don't know.
Oh, okay.
You're thinking ahead, which is good.
Yeah, so like it's just out of camera view, but I've got like a whiteboard, and I've got every month written down on it. But right after June, it's just a bunch of blank spots. So yeah. I may look like I totally have it together, like I've just got like a bunch of stuff, like, yeah man, I know what I'm doing, but beyond June, it's anybody's guess.
Well, this is where the real creativity will show up.
I might need another shot.
So April 9th. So we'll be looking forward to that as the next release. Exciting news coming up soon. All right. We will be going to Daniel now so he can do his DJ set. We'll talk to him much more after he's done with his set. And we'll see you soon.
Communion After Dark.
This is Fab from Aesthetici, and you are listening to Communion After Dark with DJ Mouse, DJ Gold, and Paradise. the best industrial show on the radio, Communion After Dark.
All tossed to ashes, burn down my churches, and give up what's holy. Fuck me and you'll never forget it. I'm a grave digger. dig you up. Honk in the trunk, there's an amber alert. Pull behind the mausoleum in the back of the church. I'm a mortal motherfucker and I hang in a cave. I'm the girl you fucking over, etching your name in your days. Everybody wants pretty girls, they say. Nobody knows pretty girls make great. Got you on a skewer so you crackle and pop. I'm not gonna stop till the box drops. I'm a grave digger, 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 digger. I'm a grave digger. I'm a grave digger. Follow me into the fire. Dropping my hello, gonna keep my hello. Oh, oh, yeah. We can dance in the middle, no sheets, no pillows. Rhythm make you move slow. Oh, oh, yeah. I don't need your love, I just want. Turning wild like animals. Lose it all in the FOMO. Oh, oh, yeah. We're pushing hard, make you levitate. Make you feeling no hesitation. Make you feeling no hesitation. No, 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 no. Nothing ever good happens at the 3 a.m. That's when me and you gonna come alive again. We don't have to worry about them. Nothing ever good happens at the 3 a.m. Take my heart and take my pain. Take me deep into your wicked ways. Just one more touch. One more touch.
I don't need your love, I just want a touch. I'm in a rush. Remedy, remedy. And we can stay right here and make a world escape. I'm gonna stand a little, so they can say, they can say.
Nothing ever good happens at the 3 a.m. Nothing ever good.
Hello, hello, everyone. Welcome back to Communion After Dark. I am your guest, DJ Daniel Graves, and you just heard my set. I ended it with, I can never pronounce this band's name, but I will do my best, Horsk. Mud in My Wheels from their new album, Wire, which is amazing. I highly recommend it. Before that, you heard Hereditary by Morris Black from, oh God, another thing Chicago. I can't pronounce. Fende Lobscurita. You better edit that out because
that worse than we would.
I absolutely do not speak French. Look, all of my mental energy is invested into German. It's like I cannot speak any other language.
I can only imagine. Yeah.
You can leave that in just to make me look bad. That's quite okay. Before that, you heard Unbroken by Sierra. That is off the Gone EP. And before that was 3 a.m. by Boy Epic. And of course, Gravedigger from my friends MXMS. And I kicked things off with Where the Dark Things Are by Carely. The kind of way that I wanted to structure this set was to go from kind of like a super chill, dark pop vibe all the way into just kind of loud, in-your-face industrial music. And I hope I did okay. Hope I did a good job with that.
Nice range. Great.
Got to keep it interesting, right?
Okay. Good job. Yeah, no, it's a good set. Good, very diverse. I like that. Go ahead. I know you got some questions you wanted to ask as well.
Okay. I know that nobody's touring or playing live right now, but as your ensemble live, what does it consist of right now?
That's all kind of up in the air. I mean, my keyboardist, guitarist, Elliot Berlin, recently departed after being with us for 10 or 11 years or something like that. He was playing with us, like, I think at every European show that we had since 2009 or so. And then, you know, we were finally able to bring him into the North American live band. But, you know, he spent the majority of his career like playing in other bands. And I think that he just really needed to focus on his own thing. So he's doing his kind of like black metal band Midbuild right now. And you know, he stepped away from Aesthetic Perfection to focus on that. And I wholeheartedly support him. He just dropped his brand new album. It is awesome. And I suggest everybody check it out. Of course, Joe is still in the band, but he is in New York and I am over here in Austria. So it's not like we have many opportunities to meet together in person. Who is going to sort of fill the shoes of Elliot is, man, that's anyone's guess. Like, Elliot is not only just like an incredible musician and performer, he's also like this incredible stage tech. A lot of people don't know that he worked as a front of house, like sound engineer in his home country of Sweden for a long time. And so he was basically the guy that like made everything happen, you know, for like Aesthetic Perfection live shows. So he'd like walk into the venue and be like, okay, you do this and you plug that in here and blah, 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 blah. And me and Joe would just be like, kind of, Elliot's doing his thing. So I think we're going to have to hire like 20, 30 people to fill Elliot's shoes. We'll see. we'll see what happens. But you know, it's like for the time being, I figured that I didn't want to stress myself out too much trying to assemble a live band because, you know, live shows are just kind of super unpredictable. And I felt like, you know, as I was saying in the previous segment, like I'm trying to focus on things that I can do as opposed to things that I might be able to do, or, you know, it's like things that are out of my control. And it's like, what's in my control right now is writing and releasing new music. So it's kind of what I'm investing all of my time and energy and resources in. And when things begin to open up again, then I think kind of the way the universe works is it will present specific opportunities and, you know, just kind of see where that leads.
All right. Okay. So my question would be, at least one of the questions I may have for you. I see you're one of the more put this a vocal artist. I see you, you know, you're on, you have your own, you talk a lot, you have your own show. I mean, where you're, I mean, talking to, and then you have your YouTube, which is the I Am Daniel Graves YouTube.
Yeah.
So check that out. If you haven't already, go subscribe to his YouTube. I did see you have a new video out, which has gotten a large amount of love already, called What is Industrial Pop?
Yeah.
So you coined that phrase. At least I believe you coined that phrase. I think we could say that. I don't know if it was existing before you said it. Maybe it was, but I don't remember. I know it's become much more prevalent since you brought it up a number of years ago.
Yeah.
So, you know, if I mean, I don't, I know this would take a long time to explain everything about industrial pop, but what was the original idea behind, you know, when you coined that phrase, or the idea behind, you know, bringing that up originally with your music?
Yeah, just like you, I am not entirely sure who came up with the name industrial pop, so like I'm very reluctant to take credit for it.
Sure.
You know, I think Kanga's used it. I've certainly been the most vocal torch bearing person, you know, for that genre and title and all of that kind of stuff. So, you know, and I don't want to like pretend like I'm the first person to ever come up with this. I don't want to pretend like I'm the person who came up with, you know, with the genre name or anything sure. like that. But for me, really, it's just kind of about embracing all of my own personal influences, right? Like, I grew up with top 40 music on the radio. As I got older, I fell in love, really, with like industrial music. And, you know, I never really saw, like a wall between the two things. You know, I think a lot of people have this idea in their head that these are two distinct worlds, and that you know, there's no way of bringing them together, and
right.
and I never felt that way, and as aesthetic perfection has progressed, as I've become not just more confident about who I am as an artist and a songwriter, but more comfortable incorporating all of my own individual tastes into what it is that I do, and you know, sort of seeing the pushback that garnered, you know, a lot of people saying like, oh, you know, Aesthetic Perfection is an agrotech band or a purely industrial band, or you know, whatever right. kind of label was slapped on me at the beginning. You know, I've tried very hard to carve out my own niche, my own sort of like world for what it is that I do, and I think that industrial pop is a great not only is it a great sort of descriptor, it's also something that pisses people off. and I think
it gets them talking.
Yeah.
But that's the thing is, like, you know, industrial music was meant to sort of challenge people, right? Challenge mm-hmm. people's preconceived notions of what music is supposed to be. And now, you know, 40 years on, we're in this place where we've got a whole bunch of people who are comfortable in what they believe that industrial music is. And I think that industrial pop is a great sort of way to challenge their preconceived notions about what their sort of subculture underground music is supposed to be. So if you watch the video, I really talk about the original intent of like Genesis Bjorge and Throbbing Gristle and sort of their philosophy of what it is that they were doing, and how that sort of circles back and relates to what it is that I'm doing. So I'm not going to ramble on here for 15 minutes like I do on the YouTube video.
Sure. No, I understand.
I certainly do recommend checking it out. It's kind of like a industrial pop 101, so to speak.
Right. And then again, your YouTube page is I Am Daniel Graves, all one word.
All one word.
Yep, subscribe to his channel. He's got a large amount of videos up there. Now, I did notice as well that you've done a couple of singles since you started the new process that you're working through your Patreon. Mm-hmm. And we should probably give your Patreon information as well if you want to provide that, because I don't have that in front of me.
It's pretty easy. It's just patreon.com/Daniel Graves. I try to keep, like, you know, my internet identity as like easily memorable or findable as possible. So it's like, You can either find me everywhere as just Daniel Graves, and if that was taken, it's I am Daniel Graves. Keep nice. It simple.
All right. There you go. So go support him on Patreon. Now, you've done a couple of songs, and I believe the artist is from has some dealings with Rammstein, if I'm not mistaken. Sebastian?
Yeah. So my guitarist. My friend Sebastian, who was playing guitar with Lindemann at the time. And,
okay, Lindemann.
Yeah, so that's the solo project of Till Lindemann, right. The singer of Rammstein. Mm-hmm. We were lucky enough to be the direct support band for his tour that he did actually just about a year ago. So it was like February, March in 2020. And we were lucky enough to be the direct support band on that tour. It was an amazing opportunity for us. I mean, it's like, in the 20 years that I've been doing this, like I never had the chance to play in an arena, which is just pretty like,
oh yeah, that's awesome.
Crappingly yeah. scary, but also really fun. Sebastian was playing with him at the time, and you know, we hit it off, remained friends since then. And I had this like riff sitting in my head, cause I'm a pretty terrible guitarist. But I can kind of fake my way through a riff, and for some reason I just had this riff in my head. And then I got back from tour and I played it on my guitar, and I was like, I think Sebastian could absolutely play this way better than me. So I just hit him up randomly. I'm like, hey dude, why don't you play on this? And then we just kind of, you know, formed a musical friendship through the internet, you know, while we're both sort of stuck at home. And he's just basically played guitar on, I want to say, one, two, three. So as of June, he will have played guitar on 4 of the 6 singles, because he's just such an amazingly talented guy. And I feel like I don't know. There's this sort of unspoken ability to understand what the other one is thinking, which is quite rare in a musical sense. Like, I've never sort of experienced that before. So I'm super lucky to, I texted him the other day. I'm like, dude, I'm so glad I found you, because without you, I would have never been able to bring these songs to life in this way. And he's just like, oh, stop. You're flattering me, but it's totally true. It's totally true.
Yeah, it definitely adds an element to the music for sure. Yeah. And I think it brings some of the songs alive. I mean, it's great. He's very talented for sure. I mean, you know, and then, like you said, playing with Lindemann, you know, great name and great artist as well. So, yeah. So we'll talk to you some more, you know, in the next set. We're going to go to the last set of the show. Do not go anywhere, because you'll hear some music. We'll talk to Daniel. We are going to read our donations as well, because we want to make sure we get those in. And then we will be going to the last song of our show, and we will be saying goodbye to Daniel, which will be sad, but we really thank him for being here. Come back and we'll hear some more music.
This is Kanga After Dark Radio, and you are listening to DJ Paradise.
Survived. Dark people, you arrived. designed, turned on to be off. Lifeless eyes, sad mind soon gone. Memory barred, everything else stacked. Do not comply, future goes bye-bye. Designed to die, designed to die. Naked we fuck, empty we cry. Designed to die, designed to die. Naked we fuck, empty we cry. Drill, drill, until you smell this pain. Get inside, radioactive youth. Smell it's good, it's the future of mankind. First conformity, then deformity. Can you take all of your lies? Can you take all of your lies? Radioactive youth cries online. Radioactive youth dies online. Designed to die, designed to die. Naked we fuck, empty we cry.
Strip off her pants, wash her asshole. Submission.
Women can be very troublesome, Mr. Jones. But then so can little men.
Radioactivate! Youth! Radioactivate! Youth! Radioactivate! Radioactivate!
All right, welcome back to Community After Dark. I am Paradise. Paradise with an E at the end. Or is it an S in the name? Because some people call me Paradise.
That's not how you say it.
Not a dice. I'm a dice. It's a paradise, you know, like the palm trees.
Oh, like two.
Some people call me Paradise. Yeah, I am Paradise.
Do you know what that means in German? Paradise?
No, what does it mean? No, I don't.
Tomato.
Oh, great. I'm not surprised. why am I not surprised? Throwing tomatoes.
I've heard all year.
So I guess when the Suicide Commando song, Disposable Paradise, I guess he's talking about disposable tomatoes.
Really? No.
No.
Tomatoes. Oh, that's funny. All right. You just heard my last song. The band you heard was Blacklight, which is a band out of Los Angeles. The song you heard was Unknown Love. That was the Sea of Sin remix of that track. That is a Unknown Love. The remixes is just a single EP that they released from their previous album that came out last year, which was one of my favorites, synthpop favorites anyways of the year. And this, they decided to put the song out with a bunch of remixes. Good stuff. If you like that track, which I do believe is one of the best on the last album, you'll like some of these remixes as well. Prior to that, I played Zarina. And Zarina is originally from Spain. I believe she lives in New York now. I could be wrong. She may have moved back. I apologize if I'm stating that wrong. But Zarina is a new artist that is on Dark Tunes Music Group. Her song that you heard was Atomic Ad Initium. There you go. Just look at our playlist on communityafterdark.com or YouTube or wherever we put up the playlist. That's the single. It's a standalone single that she released on Bandcamp through Dark Tunes. Give her some love. She's a very talented new artist, and I've enjoyed the stuff I've heard so far. Thank you to Raphael as well from Dark Tunes for sending that track over to us.
Okay, before that, Paradise played Air Crash Bureau with the song Herschlag, another German word. Maybe I should let Daniel say it.
Herzschlag.
Like that. That's the name of the song, the Ruin Conflict remix, and that is also the name of the EP. And they're from Germany.
Classic band. Yeah, and they're on Alpha Matrix. I don't know if I put that on there or not, but they're
on... Oh, no, they're on Infected.
Oh, I'm sorry, Infected. I apologize. They're on Infected Recordings. I'm sorry. Yes, exactly. Thank you, Mouse. Sorry.
Okay, then prior to that, we heard Mouse play Dread Up.
No, Paradise played it.
Oh.
All right, Mouse!
Okay. All right, one more time. Okay, prior to that, we heard Dread Up with the song called Designed to Die, and that's from their latest Romance to Romance album out on Bandcamp.
Yeah, I tried to play a little bit of a harder set here with a few songs at the end that lightened up the mood, but second song of my set was My Scars Are Soulless. It is a band on Insane Records, and they are out of the U.S. The song you heard was A Past to Burn that is on their album Vendetta. And I started off with a band that is on Metropolis Records called Terminal. It's a new band on that label. The song was Godfire, you heard, and that is on their album Blacken the Skies. That band is actually out of South Africa, which is very interesting because you don't really see too many bands in this scene anyways out of South Africa. So there's it's pretty cool.
And I think
yeah, a few. Well, there's a few. I'm not saying there's none, but it's just cool to see that, you know, we've got another band coming out of that area. So I hope you enjoyed the set, and thank you to Terminal as well, because they had actually sent that album over to us, and I believe Metropolis provided us a promo copy as well. So thank you to the label. All right, there is my set.
Good job.
I will have the last song coming up as well, so don't go anywhere. We're going to read donations real quick, and then we will go ahead and talk to Daniel a little bit more, and we will play the last song, so stick around.
All right. So these are all monthly donations. Thank you guys so much. Remember, you can go to our website, communionafterdark.com. There's a donate button on the top, and that'll give you all the links. You could also go to our link tree, for Communion After Dark, and all the links for everything are on there. Thank you to Helium, who also helps us with our pronunciations in between shows.
We need to learn more from
Alexander Vert, Gregory Watkins Colwell, the Dark Lord of Serpents, Jorrit van Dreisch, Frederick Lapham, CD, who runs the EBM Worldwide Discord, Ruben Carter, Katja Göttinger, Stephen Hall, Steve Quinnell, Johan Rombots, Jillian Tate, Dea Decay, Dave Steinhausen, Bibliodude, our favorite commenter on Mixcloud, a wealth of information, Peter G, Amy Black, Kalani Robinson, and Mr. Phoenix.
Nice.
We also have one-time donations. We got one from Alan Radford. It doesn't say where he's from. Melissa Kovic from Middleburg, Florida. I live in Florida and I do not know where Middleburg is.
Me either. No clue.
Soiree, who says, uns. Suzanne Brophy says, always a good time on Friday afternoons.
Those last two were that you read are from Twitch. Those are from Twitch.
Oh, really? Awesome. Okay. So I've seen them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Thomas Striebel out of Germany. Thank you. Jessica Shea, a double monthly donation. I see her also on Twitch as Jessica Football. I think.
Jessica Football?
I think so. It might be Footboy.
Okay.
Huh.
Football.
She's from Roanoke, Virginia. She says, I'm enjoying the new Blue Dangle music. Also, thanks for playing all the good music you play. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessica. Thank you very much.
And then one more donation from Shy from Florida. She lives here. We know her. She says, Kat is the best. Happy belated 13th anniversary, Shy Violence.
Thank you, Shy.
Thank you, Shy.
We have one next week. We have Ted Phelps. Ted Phelps from Imperative Reaction joining us. We're excited about that. Yeah, that's going to be interesting. I haven't talked to Ted before ever. Yeah, and I saw that your last single, I saw you put up a post for Automation, that single has hit a large amount of charts. Automaton, what is it?
Automaton.
Of course, Mark says it wrong, but Automaton, I apologize. So yeah, but that single has, you had a post up where it hit all these different charts.
Yeah.
And that was pretty impressive. I mean, it's all over the place.
Yeah, it was really, it just came out of left field, to be honest, because, you know, a band like Aesthetic Perfection doesn't like chart. Yeah, it's like not something that you really even, right. It's not even something you strive for, right? Because you're just like, yeah, it's never going to happen. And when Party Monster came out, it like touched like the top 20 or something in Germany. And I was like, huh, that's pretty cool. Wow. That's pretty cool. But you know, it was like in Germany, you know, sure. For like 5 minutes or something. And I was like, oh, hey, wow, cool. And then when Automaton dropped, my inbox started flooding with like fans being like, dude, have you looked at the iTunes charts in Germany? Have you looked at the iTunes charts in America? No, of course not. And then you go on and you see that, you're like, what is happening? And then you start encouraging people to take part in it. And then you just see the position climb and climb and climb and climb. And you're like, this is just like way beyond anything I ever considered to be within the realm of possibility. So I was super, super excited to see that, super grateful. I mean, what that means for the future, I don't know, but I think it's, you know, it's just a great sort of, you know, a little milestone in the Aesthetic Perfection story. But I think it proves that we can do it. And so, you know, we're going to make a very calculated and concerted effort to like organize all the fans in a very grassroots way to get Dead Zone up into the iTunes charts. So actually, now that I'm here and this is going to go live on the 29th, I can tell you that Dead Zone, our next single, is available for pre-save and pre-order right now. And if you pre-order it or pre-save it, you could potentially help us get into the charts again, and I would be forever grateful if you would help me do so.
Awesome. That's great. Congratulations. Yeah, congratulations. You deserve it. You've been working at this for a long time. You've had a large amount of albums out over the years, and your discography is, it's like you said, it's changed over the years so much, yeah. Which I really appreciate, because you haven't stuck with that one style. And you can go back though and still listen to your old albums, and they're great. I mean, it's a different style maybe than what you're doing now, but phenomenal all the way through. You've had a great career so far, and I hope it gets better for you, because I know it's not easy in the scene to get recognized sometimes.
I don't think it's ever easy. Like, you know, it's a hard business, but you know, I think as long as you stay true to yourself and your own artistic vision, and you build like a real grassroots or organic community, that you know, you have the potential to have a career out of this. And I think that's, if I've ever done anything right, it's just trying to stay true to whatever artistic vision I have, right? So for better or worse.
You ever look back on that, one more question before you go last song, on that Necessary Response? I know you're not doing Necessary Response anymore. I know you re-released the album Under Aesthetic Perfection, but do you ever look back on that album that you put out and say maybe that was a change a little bit with your vocal style? Because prior to the Necessary Response, you know, it wasn't as much the singing, it was more the industrial sound. That Necessary Response album here in Tampa, where we live, was huge at the time, because we would play it in the clubs. People loved the album, loved the songs. They would dance to them all the time. So I mean, it was definitely a change.
I think we even came through on that Dave Vision tour in like 2008, mm-hmm. right? Didn't we play in Tampa? Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yeah. I believe mm-hmm. so.
And then we saw you in Connecticut too. We saw you up there one time.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Well, I think what a lot of people don't know about Necessary Response is the fact that half the songs from that album were intended to be on Close to Human, the debut Aesthetic Perfection record, right? So I think it was Tomorrow, Forever, and then it was Elements. Those were on the original cut of Close to Human. And I delivered it to my record label at the time, to Out of Line. And they were like, no. You can't release the album as this is. And I was like, what do you mean? And they're like, well, Aesthetic Perfection is an agrotech industrial band. You can't have these kinds of songs on your record. And, you know, at the time, like, I was trying to be a band that wasn't just, you know, heavy industrial, because for since the beginning, my vision has been to make music that is honest and raw emotionally, like regardless of the form that it takes, right? So it's happy, sad, aggressive, melancholic, whatever. It's like that's what Aesthetic Perfection was always meant to be. But it was because my record label at the time wanted to put me into this box. They were like, okay, look, you are going to be like Hosico, you're going to be like Agonoise, right? Whatever. It's like, obviously there's nothing wrong with those bands, but you know, I wanted to do something different, and they said I couldn't, and I was young and sort of eager to get into the game, and so I relented, and they said, look, these songs are cool, you can put them out as a side project if you like. And you know, I put out Necessary Response just because I wanted those songs to enter the world, but I was always very sad about the fact that Close to Human, or you know, those songs were never released as Aesthetic Perfection, that Close to Human was never released as the way I had envisioned it, because I didn't want Aesthetic Perfection to be put into this box. I wanted to always be kind of like what I've been striving for since then. You know, something that's very dynamic and varied. So it's certainly Blood Spills, the original version of it, was a stark sort of difference from what I had done on Close to Human, but the in my sort of view, they're two sides of the same coin because many of those songs were written at the exact same time.
All right, that's interesting. Yeah, it makes very very much sense because I always wondered, you know, about that, and now hearing you talk about it, that makes a large amount of sense. And but yeah, it was a. I thought the album was great, and you know, I could see where you know that changed a little bit, and everything went from there. And you've gone on the right direction, in my opinion, anyways. I mean, not that that means a lot, but my opinion, I feel you've gone in the right area because, like when you stay with Agrotech, there's like you said, there's nothing wrong with it, but I mean, you're not, you know, you want to grow as an artist, and I feel you've gone in that direction. All right, yeah. So yeah, Daniel, thank you very much. We will maybe have one more question for Daniel at the end of the show. We won't just let him leave here without saying something else to him, but I want to finish off with one more song. Hopefully you've stuck around to hear the last song. Last song is from Simon Carter, our buddy who was on the show a few weeks ago. He put out a brand new single featuring Fabsy. I believe that's how you say it, Fabsy. This is really interesting because Simon said when he was on the show, he was making a song and he was putting it in many different, basically he took a song, which the song is called Beautiful Destruction. He has done it in every different genre style that you can think of. Not, obviously not every, but he's got an industrial version, an EDM version, which is the one you're going to hear now. He also has a hard style, old school awesome. Techno. It's, I mean, the EP is pretty cool because he redid the song in every type of style he could think of, I'm assuming. And there's about 11 or 12 songs on there, but it's pretty cool. Yeah, it's a pretty cool EP. It's not just a bunch of remixes from other bands. He actually did it himself, but he did it in different styles and different genres each time. So enjoy the EDM version. This one's pretty. It'll make you happy. It'll uplift you for a little while. So enjoy. And we'll be back with some comments and talk to Daniel a little bit more, and then we're done. Come back.
Thank you.
Communion After Dark. Welcome back to our last talking part. Just got some comments to read for you. Thank you guys so much. You can leave comments on any of our social media platforms and we'll find a comment. Thank you. Scott Mack, we know him, he lives here. He says, wow, the whole set was awesome. Love the new Osico. Definitely like Mellow Code. Finally, a guest representing the Scots. That was like seven sentences all in one.
And thank you to Pete from last week, Pete Burns from Kill Shelter, for joining us from all the way from Scotland.
We got a comment from Lucita Sorosong, who says, Petite Mort is French for little death. It is to describe an orgasm, as it is said that a passionate orgasm is like a little death.
Yeah, true. We got a couple of messages about that. Yeah, it's pretty interesting.
Yep. Oh, yeah, that was the band Black Harbor that I played last week.
Yep.
Very interesting. Sean Hawk says, great show. I love the mix of different songs. The cover of Head Like a Hole hits hard. They did a great job. The three of you put on the best show. Thanks for doing what you do. And that was that Nuclear Sun band that you played last week, Mark, that did that cover of Head Like a Hole. Everybody right. loved that.
Good cover. They did a good cover with it. I mean, good job with the cover, I'm sorry, of that track.
Lee Rocha says, oh, damn, prepping for another deployment and totally pumped when Mr. Nicholson started the set. Classic movie moment. Also, Nuclear Sun, damn and wow, totally ready for another movement. You guys rock. Keep it up, and so will I.
Well, thank you, Lee, everything you do. Thank you, and good
and
luck.
And then one more. Marco F. Franz says, I like your show. We always listen to you together here on the border with Switzerland. Greetings from Lake Constance. Keep it up. Sincerely, Marco.
Thank you, Marco.
Daniel, you know where Lake Constance is?
I do. Yes, it's on the border of Germany, Austria, and Switzerland, if I am correct. Yeah.
Wow. Nice. That's interesting.
It just sounds like a beautiful area.
It is. It is nice.
Before we go, I want to thank you very much for joining our show. We truly appreciate it.
Always a pleasure. Always a pleasure.
You have been an amazing guest over the years, and we thank you for coming on, you know, the times before as well. But before we go, did you have any parting words you want to say to your fans or people that listen to your music? You know, about you know, just what to expect for you in the future. I know you've already kind of talked about the singles you have coming up each month. Your goal still is, if I'm not mistaken, is to release an album, hopefully, around the beginning of next year, maybe? Is that correct?
Yes. Well, so basically the way this whole kind of project started was that there was no way for me to continue doing all of like the side work that I do, you know, to kind of like make ends meet. It's like remixes and production and all that kind of stuff. Like if you're trying to write and release a song every single month, there's just like no bandwidth for that type of thing. So I was like, look, people really want me to do this. Then I'll just sort of say for every 10 Patreon supporters that I get, I will release a new song. So it's like we started at something like 500 supporters. And then I said by 510, okay, then January's unlocked. 520, February's unlocked. And, you know, and so on. So we needed to get 620 to unlock all 12 singles for the year. I got 120 new Patreon supporters in like 2 weeks. I thought I was going to.
That's what you did.
Dude, I thought it was going to take me all year to get that. And then, you know, the next goal was to get 650 Patreon supporters. And then I was like, look, if we reach that, then I will collect all of the singles that I've released over the year, as well as, you know, like a handful of other B-sides. And then I will release all of that as a proper album, like on physical media and all that kind of stuff, vinyl, CD, cassette, whatever. And we just surpassed the 650 mark. I think it's like, you know, as of right now, us talking, we're like 652, which is just, you know, absolutely mind blowing. Like I said, like I thought it was going to take all year to unlock all of the singles if I even got it. But the fact that, you know, it's now the end of January, end of March. And, you know, now like everything's unlocked for the rest of the year. It's like, oh crap, now I got to do all of this. But it's also good because, you know, it really means that there are people out there who give a crap about what I do and want to actually put their money where their mouths are and help me bring an album to life, which is just, you know, super incredible, super humbling. Yeah, like I said, I just feel incredibly grateful for all the people who care about what I do. I'm incredibly grateful to have you guys to, you know, continue playing my music, having me on your show, all that good stuff. And, you know, if there's anything that I want anybody out there to do, any of the listeners, is just, you know, pre-order, pre-save the new singles, help an unsigned band with no management, no like backing, anything like this. I do this all myself with the help of my Patreon supporters. Pre-save the song, pre-order the song. That makes a world of difference for a guy like me.
That's awesome.
That's all I got.
I'm glad. Yeah, no, that's awesome. I appreciate you putting the information out there. And that congratulations on hitting your goal so quick. 3 months and you're already there. That's nice.
Yeah.
It didn't take you long. I remember when you started the whole thing, you were skeptical at first. Well, it sounded like that when, you know, with the wording you were using, so I could tell you like, not sure. But yeah, that was, you got there fast. So good job. And look forward to hearing some more singles here coming up soon.
No pressure. No pressure.
Yeah. All right, Daniel. Well, thank you very much. Hopefully we'll see you on tour here in the near future once the whole world starts getting back to somewhat normalcy,
whenever it can happen. It's, yeah, you know, I'll be there.
Nice. All right. Well, we look forward to seeing you again in the future. All right. Well, I guess that's it. We'll see you next week with Ted Phelps. And goodbye. Thank you for listening and watching. Bye.
Hi, everyone.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, what do you think about the sound of from then to now?
Are you asking me, or are you asking the panel?
I'm asking you. Like, did you know your music was going to go to that style at all?
Oh man, it's really hard to know like where your mind was at like 16 years ago. Like that's crazy to me to even think that album came out 16 years ago, and the fact that we're going to be at like the 20-year anniversary, you know, in just 4 short years. I never thought that, you know, it would be really going this long. Or if I did, I don't think I really appreciated, you know, kind of what that timeline feels like, you know. I certainly look back on that whole kind of era with a bit of, I don't know, nostalgia, because, you know, it was my first release ever, and I had, you know, there's the youthful hopes and dreams and all that kind of stuff. And it's just been crushed by time. I'm just ruined now. I'm a mess. I'm an old mess now. No, I do look back on that quite fondly. It was, you know, it was a tough record to make, but it was certainly a lot of fun. And I'm, you know, it was just one step of many. And I'm just glad to still be here all these years later, you know?
Yeah. Well, that was awesome. The first release you sent us when we started playing that at the castle. I think we had the demo version of it.
Yeah, we had demo versions like 3 years before that. In like 2002, 2003, we were like, did you hear the new Aesthetic Perfection? Oh my God. Like, it blew our minds. Yeah, Nothing else like it.
I think, where was I sending those demos out from? It was like, was it on AOL chat or wherever I was finding people?
MySpace or something?
Nah, it was pre-MySpace. This is pre-MySpace, man.
No, I think it was
where we were in 2002. Like, what? How did we even get here? I don't know.
I was promoing all my music back then, either through Audio Galaxy, if you remember that, and MP3.com. Like, that's where Aesthetic Perfection began. And then, like, I found people through there and was like, yo, I'll send you a demo. And I would like burn demos and send it to people.
Those were like the bootlegs. The Aesthetic Perfection bootlegs.
It's so wild too, because like people will come up to me at like shows and they'll be like, dude, you sent me this demo like 17 years ago. Will you sign it? And it's just like, you know, I printed out the song titles on printer paper and then used scotch tape to affix it to the burned CD. And you're like, my God, this is like, you know, somebody who's half my age would have zero idea what this technology is or like how I made this happen. Ridiculous.
So yeah. Last time we saw you was 2019, November.
In October, yeah.
October, mm-hmm. Right before it mm-hmm. happened. And we saw you twice because you did Tampa and Orlando.
Yeah.
Phenomenal shows. And each one has like more energy than the last one. So that, I think that live team added to that yeah. energy. And it was just over the top. Amazing.
I think the goal always has to be like to improve. You know, you can't ever feel like you've reached, you know, some point where you are immune from needing to get better, right? So I'm constantly focused on being, you know, a better singer, a better performer, offering a better, you know, light show or whatever, you know. And it's great having Joe in the band now because Joe's such a he's got such big ideas all the time, right? So it's great having somebody in the band who's like blowing me up, being like, dude, I thought we could do this and this and this and this and this and that. And then I have to be like the guy like, no, we can't do that. No, we can't do that. Blah, blah, blah. But at least, you know, I like that you're thinking. I like that you're trying. And it's, you know, it's a totally different dynamic than what I'm used to. And I'm super excited about, you know, what the future holds, because we've certainly been texting back and forth with a lot of like wild ideas for the last, you know, 13 months.
Will someone turn off that music?
That's enough. I'm putting an end to this freak show right now.
Mm-hmm.